Teachings of Avadhoota, Dattaatreya to Yadu Chakravarti. Sri Krishna replied, "The Atman or Self is one's own friend and teacher. Wise men perceive him directly. Human birth is the most sacred of all lives and is most fitted to realize Brahman. The highly vigilant intellectuals perceive him everywhere by inference." I will narrate a story in the form of a dialogue between Yadu Chakravarti, the first of the Yadava dynasty, and an Avadhuta, who was no other than Dattatreya. Dattatreya lived as a young Brahmin, caring very little for his body. Yet he possessed great wisdom and was roaming about with no permanent quarters as a wandering hermit. One day, Yadu met the Brahmin and was filled with admiration for him. He asked the Brahmin, "O Brahmin, having a good healthy body, you are inactive. Having penetrative wisdom, you behave like a young boy. You are learned, skillful, good-looking, sweet-tongued. Yet you want nothing and behave like a dunce, a lunatic or a devil. Amidst people soaked in greed and passions, you are shining like naked fire. You live alone and yet you are full of joy. Pray, tell me the cause of this glow in you of the supreme state of bliss." To him who was full of devotion and humility, the Brahmin replied, "Wandering has been my habit, but it is not without its own reward. During my wanderings, I have come across many teachers whom otherwise I could not have met, and each one of them has taught me a very good lesson. I have acquired wisdom from them by observation and inference, and I will now narrate to you a few of my teachers and their teachings. The earth, the air, the sky, the water, the fire, the moon, the sun, the dove, the boa constrictor, python, the sea, the moth, cricket, the honeybee, the elephant, the honey gatherer, the deer, the fish, pingala, the kite, the infant, the maiden, the arrow hunter, the serpent, the spider, and the wasp. These 24 have been my direct gurus. From their actions and behaviors, I have learnt how to conduct myself in the world. I shall now narrate to you in detail what I have learnt from each one of them. Earth, feasts and calamities, fortune and deprivations, difficulties and dangers are common to man, but I must learn to live amongst them unperturbed like the earth, with the firm conviction that they are the will and dispensations of providence. Like the mountain, the life of man is solely intended for the service of other living creatures. Like the tree, I must be submissive to all, yet be satisfied with what I get and not run after sense gratification. Because I am an ascetic, I should not store or overindulge. Air. The air is not attached to anything, nor contaminated by the objects it comes across. So also, I should not get attached to any object, or the merit or sin of the contacts that come across me. As the wind carries the scent, I carry the body. Sky. The sky is all-pervading, free, limitless, unaffected by the passing clouds. So also I, the soul, though having the body, am unattached, uncontaminated with the body or its possessions. Water. Like water, the ascetic is pure by himself, transparent, soft and sweet in nature. He purifies others by mere name, sight or touch. Fire. The yogi has his two palms as the eating plate and his stomach his only vessel. Like the fire, he eats whatever is offered, makes no distinction. He does not select his food. He does not suffer any sin from what he eats. Like the fire, he is sometimes hidden and unnoticed. Sometimes he glows out and becomes visible to others and blesses them. He burns away the sins of those that besiege him. Form is the indication of fire. Brahman has no form. He manifests through a body on account of his Maya Shakti, the fire. The oil of a lamp is constantly rising up and getting evaporated by the fire in the form of a flame. Yet it appears as though the flame is constant. So also the body is dying every minute, yet appears as though it is continuously living. Moon. The waxing and waning are the changes in the rays of moon, and the moon is not affected by them. So also the changes of the body as birth, growth, etc. do not affect the Atman in the body. Sun. The sun draws water from the sea during summer and releases it as rain during the monsoon. So also the yogi enjoys objects but loses contact with them and detaches himself the next moment. Though the sun is reflected in all vessels containing water, yet he is ever free in the sky. So also the self, though manifesting in all bodies, is yet free and unmodified. Dove. A dove was loving its wife and children intensely. A hunter caught its wife and young ones in his trap. The dove, on account of his intense love, also fell into the net of the hunter and lost its life. So man should not have excessive attachment or fondness for wife, children, persons, property or objects. Great attachments bring on pain and pleasures, and man falls in his spiritual upliftment. Python. The python has a long and stout body, lives in the forest. The body is so heavy that it remains almost motionless and appears to be living without any effort. It eats whatever is obtained through providence at its mouth, sweet or bitter, small or great. Starves if no food is got, believing that also as his will. So also a wise man should not indulge in activity, should not enjoy sense pleasures. The body, mind and senses must be under his control. Sea. Though all the rivers empty into the sea, yet the sea is not concerned. It is not proud. It does not overflow. So also a sage should remain calm and peaceful, whatever pleasures or pains may overflow towards him. Moth. A moth sees a bright flame. It is enchanted by its brilliance. It falls into it and perishes. So also a man who has no control over his senses, being influenced by Maya, falls into the snares of woman and perishes. Honey bee. The bee gathers small quantities of honey from different flowers. It takes only the essence without in any way harming the flowers. So also an ascetic should receive small quantities of food from many householders without causing them any inconvenience. Also, he should gather knowledge from different scriptures, gather only the essence and offer it to the others who beseech him for the same. He should not store any food or other articles for the morrow, lest he begets harm like the bee, which by storing honey loses its life to the merciless honey gatherer. Elephant. An ascetic should not touch even the feet of a young woman. Any contact with women will bring him ruin, like the he-elephant getting caught for the sake of the she-elephant. Honey gatherer. Misers amass wealth. They do not enjoy it, nor do they willingly give it to others to enjoy. Some thieves loot it or even kill the miser and enjoy it. The bees collect honey and die because the honey gatherer kills them mercilessly before taking away the honey. Deer. The deer is fond of music, and so the hunter blows his flute. While the deer is enjoying the music, the hunter catches the deer. So an ascetic should not be attracted by music or by the sweet words of praise. Fish. Fish are slave to their tongue, that is taste. They run for the worm and get caught by the hook. A wise man should not go in for taste. Pingala. Pingala was a prostitute in Mithila. She used to dress up well and sit outside every evening waiting for some paramour, soliciting the passers-by with her looks and gestures. One day, as the night advanced and nobody came to her to give her some pleasure as well as money, she lost her sleep, gained no pleasure but only worry and disappointment. It was past midnight. She got disgusted, frustrated, and she began to reflect. How senseless, foolish, and ignorant have I been? I was swept away by my senses, desiring for some pleasure, and by greed. I have lost my sleep and my rest. I thought that I could obtain wealth and joy from a human body of flesh and bones. I am the most wicked person in Mithila. I have forsaken the Lord of my heart. I have not looked at him. He gives me real joy. It is all the grace of the Lord that has brought about this frustration and disgust for fleshy pleasures. I am really fortunate. I shall take refuge in him hereafter. He shall be my husband. I shall feel contented with whatever is got by providence. The Lord will surely save me. He is the only protector for me. Thus resolved, she went to bed and had a sound sleep. Kite. A kite had a piece of flesh in its mouth. Stronger kites began to chase and torture it. Unable to bear the torture, the kite dropped off the meat. It had no more trouble. So, acquisition is a source of danger. Man accumulating wealth begets troubles. Non-accumulation is a source of peace and happiness. Child, I wander in the world like a child, care little for honor and dishonor. The worries of a householder do not trouble me. The child and the saint are beyond the three gunas. They are free from all cares and they enjoy supreme bliss. Maiden, in a village there was a poor family. They had a daughter for marriage. Some people came to their house to look at the bride. The parents had gone out. The guests had to be provided with food. There was no rice in the house. They had only paddy. The girl began to pound the paddy. The pounding produced the sound of the bangles on her hands. She felt that others should not know her engagement. She began to remove the bangles one by one. She had only two on each hand. Even then there was sound. She removed another and left only one on each hand. There was no more sound. Similarly, company of many brings many quarrels and disputes. Even two cannot live in peace. So, ekanta, living alone, secluded, is the best way for maintaining peace. Hunter. A hunter was aiming at a bird. As he was aiming, the king passed that way on a horse and inquired if any animal had run that way. The hunter did not see or hear the king. His mind was fixed upon his aim. So also the seeker's mind, by control of breath, must be concentrated on the self with dispassion as an aid. Snake. The snake lives in holes made by other and does not worry for a house. Similarly, an ascetic must be aniketana. Aniketana, one having no resting place of his own. The supreme is also aniketana. None of the bodies are his permanent residences. Spider. The supreme creates the universe out of himself, by himself, with himself. Like the spider building the web with its own saliva, living on it and finally swallowing its own saliva. Wasp. A worm is lodged in a hole in a wall with a covering of mud and is constantly harassed by a wasp. Soon the worm turns out to be a wasp. So also the ascetic, by constant remembrance of the self, becomes the self. These are the lessons which I have learned from different gurus. This human birth is rare to obtain. Having got it, one must strive to attain liberation before the body gets destroyed. Yadu Chakravarti was greatly enlightened by these teachings of Dattatreya. He renounced all attachments and gained perfect peace.